Namaste everyone, Anu Chhabra here. As we have already discussed how to arrange a water pot in our garden, how to take care of the plants, what are the different methods with which we can grow our plants. So today I'll be discussing with you what all excess what we get from these plants. Now what happens, they multiply really very fast, they grow like a weed. So what happens when excess of these we have with us, how to use them, or what is the main use of having water plants in our terraces. Now the first thing is, whenever we have water plants in our terrace, so birds and other insects, they come to drink water. At the same time, they'll not just come drink water and go, they'll just roam around in our terrace. They may eat some of the pest, whatever attacks are happening in our plants, or at the same time the poop of all the birds, they are really very much rich in nutrition, which is required for our plants. So if you are going for a vegetable garden and we really want to control our pest, then water plants are the really best ones to attract all the birds to your plant, which will directly or indirectly, you can say, they'll manage our pest attack in our plants. Now what happens, as I told you, because these are a weed kind of a thing, they grow really fast. So what happens when, after 6 to 8 months, when we repot our plants, so we have excess of these plants. So there are few ways with which you can use them. The first is, if any of you have your gardening friends who really want to grow them, you can share with them. But how much you will share, if still after sharing something is remaining, we should know how to use it. Now the thing, whatever we have collected, now see, this much excess was there, so I have kept it in water only. If somebody wants, few of my friends, they'll come and take it, else I'll dry it like this. I'll take it out of the water. Within 3 to 4 days it'll become dried completely. Similarly this azolla, these all are very rich source of all the micronutrients, as you can say, the seaweed, the liquid seaweed, what we use it for our plants for their better growth, these exactly work like that. So either you can dry them like this, after it dries you can just touch it, it will become like a powdery thing. This takes little more time to dry because this is a little bigger. These dry a little fast. You can use it as a mulch, or if you use it in your compost bin, so makes your compost faster. Making of the compost, composting will be faster if you add these things to your compost. Or while making a potting mix also, you can mix them to make your soil really rich in all the micronutrient content. One more benefit is there, when we are growing these water plants, as I told you, this water is full of all the nutrients because of the fish and the other things of the plants. So what we can do is, we can just weekly once, we can take out this much water from the plant, from the pot, and one by one we can plan to give it to all our plants. You should not take out all the water. 1 or 2 glasses per week is more than sufficient, what you take it out from your water pot, and plan accordingly that first these 2-3 plants you have to give, next week the other plants. So every time some plant or the other is getting this enriched water. So this much water is more than enough for this much plant. So once in a month or once in 2 months also, if this much water any of my plant are getting, so all the nutrients, whatever it needs to have a proper growth, that will be provided by this water. So indirectly it's a nutritionally rich water what we are preparing with the help of fish. So try growing that. Now one main problem, it comes when we grow these, after few days small snails start appearing. So if possible, see, these snails will be there in the pot. So there is, if you want to work as an ecosystem, you want to manage, then these snails are a really rich source of calcium. You can collect them You can, if bigger ones are there, you can just hand pick. You can collect them, crush them. So some people, they use it as a source of calcium, or you can let them keep it in a container. So after a few days, that whatever the dyed ones are there, that you can use it in your compost, or you can throw it wherever you want away from your terrace. Now, how to collect them? The easiest way is the cabbage what we eat, the normal cabbage. So just collect. Anyways, whenever we eat cabbage, initially one or two leaves we discard. So those leaves, you store it and try keeping it. If you see, I have put it in these. So what happens? Yeah, you see, such a big snail. You saw? So like this, snails are really, you can say, a very good source of calcium. So if you want to collect and put it in your thing, that's more than enough. Otherwise, what happens, they do not do anything harm as such, but only thing is they try eating the leaves of the other plants. So if you really want to pick them, so keep these cabbage leaves overnight. Morning, you just lift this cabbage leaves, and these, as I told you, these snails, they love eating cabbage. So all they'll be cling around this. You can just lift it and you can throw it apart. So this is the way we can manage our, you can say, whatever the challenges we feel in growing these water plants. It's a very easy way, because they create their own ecosystem. No hassles, no watering required. As in, when the water reduces, you have to fill the till the brim. Make sure whenever you are growing water plants, always keep the tub filled with water, because the sunlight what they get, it will be fully, they'll receive if they are till the water is till the brim. Otherwise, gradually they'll start becoming yellowing. And make sure whenever some decaying leaves or some dried leaves you see, try removing that. Otherwise, that will start decaying, and might be some rotting smell can come. So these are the basic things. If we take care, they are the very integral part of our vegetable gardening. So try growing it. Very easy. Don't forget to add fish, which is also a main part. Without that, this is not possible. Otherwise, every now and then we have to keep changing water. That will be a little tiresome job. So thank you very much for joining me. Keep watching for some